to be here with the film about my dad, and screenings have been going great, and my dad's been a great sport, and we're so happy that he's here and that he's going to play, we've gotten a great reaction to the film, and we're having, I think, our only screening that's not sold out is tomorrow morning at 9 a.m., so if anybody hasn't seen the film, we'd love you to come tomorrow and join us. We're really happy with it. Okay, my dad's a little nervous that he comes off curmudgeon-y in the movie. Okay, Ramblin Jack Elliott.
Thank you.
Ayiana, that was great. The bright lights.
This is the song from the Pennsylvania mountain, stranded up there in the snow, off a Bob Dylan record. Thank you, Bob. Don't think.
Got this guitar in Melbourne, Australia. It's not used to the climate here. I'm gonna take up ukulele anyway. Almost couldn't fit it on the airplane. They're making the planes bigger and bigger, but they're making the seats smaller and smaller. And the baggage compartment is also smaller, and I had like quarter of an inch difference is all I needed. Practically had to mash the plastic lid on the damn door to get it shut to keep from giving it to the downstairs cargo bay agents. Here's the song. Well, it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe, if and you don't know by now. And it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe, it'll never do somehow. When your rooster crows at the break of dawn, look out your window and I'll be gone. You're the reason I'm traveling on, but don't think twice, hair up's all right. And it ain't no use to calling out my name, gal, like you never done before. No using a calling out my name, gal, 'cause I can't hear you anymore. Thinking and a wondering and a walking down the road, how I once loved a woman, a child, I'm told. Ayiana, June, Jan, Barbara, Polly, Flossie, Tuffy, Daisy Mae. Oh, anymore, but don't think twice, it's all right. Eleanor. That's my aunt. She's 94. You'll see her in the movie. She's one of the stars of the movie. She gets real. She's my mother's sister. But evidently, she didn't like my mother. And she got it all out on film there. It's all there for everybody to see. Rosie O'Donnell loves my Aunt Eleanor. She's had her on the show about 8 times. Aunt Eleanor makes these, what are they called? Chocolate truffles. I've never had a truffle myself. Have you ever had a truffle? Yeah. Well, we got some classy people here tonight. This gentleman's had a truffle. I don't eat It's something that pigs know how to make. I don't know what. How do they do it? It's something in France. Is it up near the Belgian border? Somewhere near Kortrijk. That's where they had Derroll Adams' birthday party. They couldn't have it anywhere, not like Stockholm or anything. So they did it in Kortrijk, and they did it in a 900-seat opera house. Every seat was filled. I was the guest of honor. I couldn't even remember the words to the songs. Been so long since I seen Derroll. Now he's over there fixing it. He's sick, and he's not well, and he can't play the banjo anymore. And we're filming this thing. This is going out to Derroll Adams. All the way from Woody Guthrie and Bob Dylan and Bob Gibson and all those crazy fuckers for you, Derroll. Because Derroll Adams, he wasn't just a banjo player and an artist. He was a cowboy in Oregon before he got into that, and he went to, he was a windfall bucker in Oregon. Windball fucker? No, windfall bucker. It's a logging term. So long, honey, babe. Where I'm bound, I can't tell. I'm gonna have to hire an Australian guy to tune my guitar. See that now. So long. Fare thee well. Thanks for listening. Thanks for looking. And if you drop by Elko on your way out to the coast, I'll sing a song or buy a drink or we'll recite you a poem. Yeah, there's a scene in there where I was on the Johnny Cash TV show. It's probably the only time that they ever had somebody go out of tune on the show. And I mean, I don't usually like going out of tune. I like it tonight. It's usually a pretty darn painful thing. But I think it's suitable. It's very appropriate, don't you?